Alright, I'm sorry, the last video was awful. I had to shorten it, and I don't know, sometimes I say inappropriate things. I understand. Sorry for that if you heard it on the out. And so I'll try to make a, what do you call it? I was trying to go back to speaking about the crystal maker series that I was talking of the planet itself being the same event, the planet itself being a rock organism. If you look at the planet with the water, it's simply a rock organism with the incoming asteroids, the incoming meteors, incoming changes to the atmosphere. Also, all of these are incoming events. All of these are either their attractions to it. Their attractions to it to build it. So the Earth itself is built every single time it receives an asteroid. Every time it receives a meteor, it's built. It gets higher, you know. It gets more land mass, and so that's the rock itself is building, so its own conglomeration, and for some reason, yeah. So we've changed the you know, by all of this order process. We need this and we need that, and we have to have this steel. Or we have to have this other. So we've changed this makeup of the Earth, of this planet. And so here it is zonking in, and so we're getting new attractants, we're getting new attractant energy, we're getting new planets getting turned on by whoa, you're sounding different, and maybe that is my sound, and maybe that planet's attraction is not the right planet attraction, you know. So we're having these types of movements happen. And it's like, you know, this one was over here, maybe quite dangerous to humankind, mankind, planet, animal kind. All of a sudden, we've wrenched out these items, we've changed the resonance, and so now it's turned itself, and it's looking at us, you know. And so it's like, whoa. And so now we are in a new attraction state, whether we wanted to be in this attraction state or not. And it is like, are you kidding me? You know, you can't have it. You can't have all of a sudden like this. And it's no way to turn it away unless all of the misdeeds of human type, unless all of those misdeeds are undone. And that would mean going away from the Middle Age at all. So it almost is like no humans, you know. Because the humans themselves are just like pluckers out of everything, out of the belly of this sucker. So this is a major event, I'm thinking, you know. So there we are. We're having new energies, new attractions, is it a fight event? There could be, yes, a fight event going on. That perhaps there was something that was a normal attraction to the planet, and you know, this is a normal, beautiful, before the humans, everything was going lovely, and then you have all of a sudden the like a you know, this was supposed to be you know, back to dinosaurs or whatever, you know. Everything was going great, and that was just be a happy landing place, and almost as like a love tap. It could be like a love tap event, you know, that you know, I was supposed to get a massive asteroid there, and that is just like if you think of the chi on your body, you think of this as it comes in, the sprinkle of the chi on your body, you know, you're just getting an extra power out moment, a power event. And it was supposed to happen there, but maybe it's not attracted anymore to us, you know. Maybe we have made the planet an unattractive state, and so it's no longer getting love, you know. So that is a sadness, because it'll go elsewhere. That one that was on some kind of a pull energy before. is not feeling it. It doesn't have it anymore. It's a different sound, isn't it? It's a different sound. It hears. It's a different energy. It's not going there. It's going elsewhere. So we've lost that. We've lost a good, beautiful. And it's interesting because mankind is like, oh no, asteroid hitting the Earth is not a beautiful, not a beautiful for them. You know, it's destructive to them. But it is a beautiful for the Earth itself. You know, in the right experience before we became such an overpopulated aggression. Because we're now such an overpopulated aggression against all things planet, and this hyperbuild of everything, hyperbuild and destroy, because all of this has gone on. So now we're having these new accumulants being attracted, and these ones are maybe not the love give to the Earth. You know, it's not the love give anymore. These ones are some heavy spikes in. You know, and. Yeah, you just put two magnets together and watch them snap like this, you know, and maybe that was not really the way we were supposed to be, you know, not this type. So I don't know. I'm thinking how it's almost like we created a war environment. Planet itself, it's almost like it's creating its own terminator. Its own terminator cell, but the Earth itself is now its own terminator cell, just like the movie, one of those organics that just, you know, are just like, I have now become this evil metal out procadide or something, you know, that's just out here, and now I'm having attractions to others, you know, that are of my same ilk. And so we are just going to be bonding this conglomerate again, this massive conglomeration. We're going to be bonding around and becoming a terminator planet. Now it does not matter the human any longer. You've been the one who gave. You've been the one who's actually delivered the items, haven't you? You've been the one who's delivered the items to create the terminator planet, but now here we are. And so what does the terminator planet do? It could be anything, really. It doesn't really care of animals, it doesn't care of any of the plants growing, it does not care of the salinity level, give or take, it doesn't care even pollution floating around, it doesn't even care the nuclear habitation overflows, it doesn't care any of this, it doesn't care. No, Terminator planet is different, isn't it? So oddly, man has been a supplier to this creation of a Terminator planet, self. You can call it a self, a little self organism. So there it is. Yeah. So what is the love now? What is the love for it? Give me a big hit of some Magnetica. Give me something like this. You know, just give it to me now. You know, that's what it's saying, and it's a powerhouse for it. It's a powerhouse for it. So that's really. I'd prefer to stay there in this particular topic because this is a. We're completely indispensable completely, who cares? You just brought it out, you know. Maybe I keep you around, you can bring out some others, you know. Bring out some other humans that back me up, you know. So I start thinking, well, maybe all of these evils that won't change, you know, they're just excited by new advancements as long as they take and as long as they are, what do we call it, resource takers? Yeah, maybe they're just part of the seed of the evil Earth, the new evil Earth that the initial thefts occurred from. initial thefts. The thefts. Yeah, it's just like this. See how changing? We're changing our hue, aren't we? We're just changing. We're not the same any longer. So once we've changed our color of our rainbow, you know, who are we? Just bring it on, everyone. Just bring it on. We've got a new freaking fire planet here. What's going on? We're going to go for Mars. We're going to be like Mars. Is that who we are? Doesn't care, man is saying. Doesn't care about your words, literary form of what existentialism is. It doesn't care. It's a planet. It's a planet with an agenda of the attraction of what is on the outer and what is on the inner, and how it is played out. And right particularly now, this doesn't look comfy cozy for the human, does it? Doesn't look comfy cozy for the human. So all of these advancements, it does not look comfy cozy for the human. And the human has made these advancements for their own little cup of coffee there, or their own brew out, haven't they? They have made these advancements, and they forgot about volcanoes, and they forgot about the planet itself and what it's up to. They forgot about sequencing. They forgot about the cycle of it and how many times it even swirls around, and how this can change. How this changes just by the middle, on the out. They forgot about this, didn't they? They forgot about this. So are y'all feeling high? Are we floating around? Are we floating around high feeling? Or is that just me? Maybe it's just me. Maybe I have some, what do you call it, I get into it first. I'm one of those. I'm really in tune with the freaking gosh dang. I get into it first. I have to hear all of this planetary upset first. Yeah, the Terminator makers are the humans. The Terminator makers. I'm sorry, it's taking me so long to spit it out, you know? Just the Terminator makers, that's all. It's just gonna be an ugly, ugly gosh damn place, and you know it's just gonna be ugly.